Hey everyone, this is Dom from Tech Advisor, and I'm here with a very special phone, a special edition phone, the Nord 2 Pac-Man Edition from OnePlus. I'm going to give this a quick unboxing, have a play around, and show you some of the cool features, little Easter eggs, and hardware secrets OnePlus has hidden inside this cool little phone. All right, so we have a very colorful popping out box. And on the inside of that, we have the actual phone box, the Pac-Man edition of the Nord 2. You'll see the design of the box has this kind of maze illustration, labyrinth thing that's very Pac-Man-y. Obviously, it's also a nod to the phone itself, we're gonna see. But you'll notice little bits, there is a OnePlus logo in there. There's a Nord written in the labyrinth. It's quite nicely done. Getting in, more Pac-Man, more OnePlus, so you know what you're getting. Let's get into here. We have some of the normal sort of OnePlus stuff, though there are little touches. So the customary message from OnePlus to its fans whenever you buy one of their phones now is greetings, player one. Lines like, we hope you're hungry for a new adventure. So for OnePlus fans who are used to kind of a lot of stuff from OnePlus being very static, this will be quite fun to see the little differences you'll find. We also have, as you'd expect, some stickers, though now in a nice Pac-Man yellow for the Nord. Though I'm surprised there's not actually like a big Pac-Man-y sticker in there. That would have been nice, right? And that is just the quick start guide and stuff like that. Okay, elsewhere in the box, we have our little This Way Nord pop-up. I get through that. Nothing hugely exciting, but that is our charger. I'll get to the specs of the phone later, but this is the same Warp Charge 65 charger that you get with the regular Nord 2. So it's 65 watt charging, very nice. Get that back in there. Here, of course, we have the phone itself. Set that aside just for the moment, we'll come back to it. In here, OnePlus charging cable, standard red. I kind of thought we might see a yellow one for this or something like that. They've done colored cables before. But no, this is a standard red cable. And there is one last secret, if I can get it open. I know hidden in here, we have a secret case compartment. OnePlus does like to hide things. And here is the first time the box gets really Pac-Man-y. So this is the official included case for the Pac-Man phone, which is pretty fun. Obviously, it's got the Pac-Man logo, it's got the ghost Pac-Man itself. And it's a pretty solid feeling case, actually, much more so than I'm used to getting from free included in box cases. Though I can't remember how it compares to the one you got with the original Nord 2. So here is the Pac-Man edition OnePlus Nord 2. Straight away, we notice the design is different. The actual shape of the phone and everything has stayed the same, as you'd expect, but the rear is now totally different. Gone is that classic blue finish we saw on the original Nord 2. Now it's this sort of steely silver. We can see we have a little Pac-Man. We have the grid of palettes for him to pick up. OnePlus logo has moved down to the corner to get out of the way. But we also have a little OnePlus X Pac-Man written on the corner right by the camera module. Other subtle little details. The alert slider is now a really nice kind of rich steely blue, which just goes with the rest of the color palette pretty nicely. Other than that, everything looks pretty standard from a hardware perspective, at least in the light. One of the little secrets about this phone, the OnePlus has already teased it, is that it is glow in the dark. So set this phone in a dark enough space and you will see the back design change with that labyrinth from the box animating across the back of the phone in green glow in the dark lines. I have to caveat this, we have tried so hard to film this, but it's really difficult filming things in the dark. Anyone who's used night mode on a phone will know this. The effect is a little more impressive than it may look in our photography. We are doing our best to get the most out of it. It is worth caveating though, like all glow-in-the-dark things, this has its limits, shall we say. If you leave it in a dark space for too long, the effect fades because there's not enough light for it to reflect. So this really works for short bursts of going into dark spaces where, you know, on entering a darkened room, the phone will start glowing as long as it was somewhere light beforehand. But do not expect a phone that is perpetually glowing all evening long, because that is not really what you're gonna get here. Okay, so that's the hardware. Let's get into the actual software of the phone, where there are a few more surprises. Okay, so from the moment you turn the Pac-Man Edition phone on, you are greeted by all things Pac-Man. From the setup process, through to the boot up animation, through to just details like getting on and finding immediately a big beefy Pac-Man wallpaper. In fact, there's a whole selection of Pac-Man wallpapers installed in here by default, some of which are just flat images, some of which are animated live wallpapers like this one. You also find Pac-Man ringtones and notification alerts. All of that's there from the get-go. You're also going to get things like a lot of the standard app icons for OnePlus's own apps have now been rendered in pixelated versions to really sell home that retro gamer aesthetic. So from the camera app to the gallery, going into stuff like the calculator, even OnePlus's clone phone tool or its community forum as app. I'll admit it does slow me down a little bit. The camera icon is not immediately clear to me that it's a camera anymore and has given me pause a couple times when I've gone to open that. But still, it's a fun little touch. While we're on apps and app icons, you are also going to find pre-installed on the phone Pac-Man 256, which is one of the later sort of modern reinventions of the Pac-Man experience, I guess, designed for phones. So you're getting a free game with it too, which is pretty fun. One of the other things I want to talk about is I mentioned camera, and there is a fun little camera mode. OnePlus has enjoyed playing around with camera filters on its phones recently, sometimes to good effect, sometimes throwing in whole lenses just for single filters that we have not been impressed by always. There is a fun one here. There is a Pac-Man filter that comes pre-installed in the camera app. And basically this just means that there are little ghosts and Pac-Man figures darting across the screen as you try and take your photo. What's fun about that is they do stick around in the final photo, but because they are moving, they'll be in different spots every time you take a shot. So it's not quite the same as a really sort of static Pac-Man sticker being applied to your shots or anything like that. These are all the really obvious little Pac-Man touches. Some are more subtle. Some are things like you'll have noticed perhaps that the time widget on the home screen is now in yellow, which it wouldn't normally be. If I go down here, everything, the whole UI is in blue and yellow. When I go into the sort of settings panel, there's actually a little Pac-Man icon as I switch between panes of all my notification settings, which is pretty fun. Control center, sorry. Some things are even more hidden though. There are Easter eggs in this phone, which is appropriate for a gaming device. I'm gonna be upfront, I have struggled to find them. Smarter men than me, or smarter people than me, may be needed to solve this one. I've played around a little bit, I figured one out, but I don't want to give it away. Not least because apparently it's one of the last ones you're meant to get, and it doesn't work until I've solved things before that, which I haven't solved. So clearly, this may be a process of working through this phone, finding stuff. But yeah, OnePlus has encouraged fans to really dig through a lot of the apps and try different bits and pieces to unlock new wallpapers, new ringtones, new other features, even more than what is already pre-installed on the phone. So if you're a fan, particularly if you're a Pac-Man fan, obviously, there is gonna be a lot to love here, and genuinely they have gamified the phone itself in a way which is really welcome. You may have also noticed this pretty slick little, well, OnePlus calls it a phone holder in the sense that you can sort of put the phone there and it will sort of stay upright. I don't know how many people are going to use this as a phone holder. It is a lot of fun. I'm not actually sure if everyone gets one of these, or if this was a little reviewer perk for me. It is a, I don't know, legally distinct from Lego construction, which itself plays a part in the Easter eggs in the phone. When I mentioned I'd solved one, I solved one related to this, but there's more within the phone itself to figure out, which is pretty cool. Other than that, this is a Nord 2. This is also the top spec version. This is only available in the 12 gig RAM, 256 gig storage variant of the phone. So you can only get the highest SKU essentially of what the Nord 2 is available for. If you are hoping for big spec bumps compared to the original Nord 2, I could see you might be disappointed, but there's really no need. The Nord 2 is a fantastic phone. It is actually still our main mid-range phone recommendation, and in fact we just gave it the Tech Advisor Mid-Range Phone of the Year 2021 award, which shows how much love we have for the Nord 2. And that's just the regular version without all this cool extra Pac-Man stuff thrown in. Like the Nord 2 though, this is coming out in Europe and India, and as far as I'm aware, the Pac-Man edition is not getting a North American release. Neither did the original phone. So sorry to any Americans watching, you may have to import this one if you've got your heart set on it. That's all from me. Please let me know in the comments if you own one of these things and if you managed to find more of the Easter eggs that I missed, because I'm sure there must be loads that I have been completely oblivious to as I've been playing around with the phone for the last day or two. Remember to like and subscribe. Stay tuned for the channel for more things coming soon. Until then, bye for now.